Whoa, so I'm excited to show you this. The boss here. It was probably loud. Double recording the sound. Up. There we go. Yeah, so this drop boss is so much more fun now. The hammer boss. Let's fight him here at level 1. This is like level 1 items and stuff. What's up, Pedro? Go, Pedro! What's up, Mighty Mess? So at level 1, he drops a few rocks. He's somewhat intelligent. He has his regular damage. At level 9, oh, there's a zoom in now. That's pretty cool. Zooms in on the boss for a second. And then at level 9, let's get out a level 9 save really quick. I got two of these ready to go. Level 9, he's so much harder. What's up, Arcane? Level 9, he does double damage. He has this charge attack, so he can run really fast and hit you. He drops a lot more rocks, and he's a lot smarter about doing his hammer. So he's getting a lot better. Actually, I'm pretty sure he's good to go. This is like level 9 boss ready to be really, really tough to beat. He uses up pretty much all my health to fight this guy. He's a lot smarter too at level 9. He actually can recover from an attack pretty fast and start seeking you faster. So all in all, this is much more appropriate for like a level 9 boss. In fact, he's gonna start bombing the hell out of it. Stopped in his tracks. So before, he had massive of 1.0, which means that he never ever got stopped. So that's pretty cool too. And also, the shield is a lot cooler too. So if I let him hit my shield, he'll bounce off a little bit, even though he has massive 1.0. See that? He's dead. Oh, and a cactus eating right there. So you can tell. Level 9 is a lot more appropriate. It's more difficult than level 10 or level 1. So, any plans to make the higher level version look slightly different, like a red hue? Maybe. I guess I hadn't planned that yet, but that could totally work. Just make him darker or something. Huh. That's a good thought. Good thought. Let me think about how to best do that. Maybe I could simply do that by just changing the color a little bit. I could really do that by making another skin. So there's one problem though with the level 1 boss. His music for some reason isn't playing. It's fun to watch, good. If it's fun to watch, that's a good sign. Okay, so yeah, you can hear that the boss music is not playing. It's playing the regular music. And then if I run level 9, I think it plays the music. Which is weird. Gotta fix this. But the next thing I'm gonna work on is making it so when you get the demon's tooth, yeah, we got appropriate boss music there. Right. Okay, so my next task is to debug why it's not playing the music for the boss at level one. Oh, is there an I intelligence to that? Nah, see, this should happen no matter what. If mode one, mode zero, timer, delay, dir, music, boom. It should hit that music every single time. So something's wrong with the music at level one. I wonder what what's going on here. Looks good, nice, good to know. Whoops. Ah, so it might have had a silence timer. See what's up with this. Set a breakpoint here. Figure out why this music isn't playing. I think it's probably has a silence timer in level 9. Okay, there. It's hitting this music. Yeah, and it had a silence timer already. Okay, that's the problem. That's the problem. Silence timer. So where does it get this silence timer from? Let's see. And why doesn't it get it at level 9? Thanks, Pedro. Thanks for saying that. Pedro, how, by the way, how's this month's game going? Are you working on a game this month? What's the concept? You probably already told me. Sorry if you already told me. Oh, here we go. Story system run actions. Story system plays music. Oh, okay. This makes sense. It's playing the story music here. Okay, all right. This is fine. There's nothing broken with this system at all. It's just that it's playing story systems music, which is meant to happen when you come out of the level, like level one or something. Let's go to story. Music level one. Music level one plays this special music and puts a silence timer, so it forces this music to play. So what I want to do is go to my save one and say that we've already played music level one. So there. Now this save file is a little more appropriate. I can copy that, run it, and now we should have some music. What's up, QLab? Hey guys. Welcome, welcome. There we go. Cool. We got boss music again. Awesome. All right. So there's one little bug fix. Not really a bug. Next thing. Okay. I want it. So when you kill the mini, when you kill the boss, I want the demon's tooth to come riding out of the sky or from the ceiling on like a beam of light and a platform. So it'd be a lot cooler than just. Right now, it's the same hidden chest system as everything else. So after this guy dies, the hidden chest will come out. So yeah, that's cool. I mean, but you've seen this a lot of times already in the game. So I want the demon's tooth to have its own special item emit thing where it basically comes riding out of the sky. So that's today's task right now. And if there's time in today's stream, I'm also gonna do one new enemy. Pedro worked on his game 2 days and paused. Been messing with user tests for your thesis. Oh, your thesis is coming up right now. That's right. It's about a bull in a bull ring arena that kills people before they kill him. Whoa, that's a cool concept. This month's theme is deadlines coming. Finish your thesis or face the consequences. Whoa. Oh, Chaotic, are you the one working with Pedro on the 1 month, one game a month things? That's cool. I think you are, right? Okay. How am I going to get the item to ride in on a beam of light? Where to start? First thing, it probably needs to be inside an item component without a chest. That's right. Awesome. That's really cool. You guys are making some sweet stuff. Yeah, I'm proud of you guys. You guys are like making a lot of progress. Probably learning a lot of stuff too, I'm sure. Nice. Okay, so area, it creates the item. This is create item. There's actually create items. Yeah, here we go. We're creating the item entity. Now, if it's a boss and it's the demon's tooth, I want it to ride in on a beam of light. Best pros not. Oh man, I just remembered something I want to do before this. He's prettier than you and gets all the girls. Oh, well, that's good, man. That's great. You can use that to your advantage. You can both get girls that way. Yeah, so this area right here, the before boss area, I want that to have two item chests. So you can refill some life right before you fight a boss. Always, I want there to be at least two health that you can get back. So worst case scenario, if you enter this before boss room and you only have one heart, you at least have three. And if you're higher, then great, good for you. But there's two more backups if you need them. If you're speed running, you're not even gonna stop and get them. So that should be pretty good. Here's where we got statue, boss. Where does it put the chests? Oh, there it is, life chest. Oh yeah, life chest. All right. Now pattern before boss. Same thing, we want some life chests. Not up high. Let's go H2 minus 4. Let's see what that's like. At least I code better than him. Zilton, what's up, man? What's up with your iPad? Maybe you gotta restart it. My iPad was acting so weird today too. When I plugged it into my computer, it just sat there and kept plugging in and plugging in. It was the weirdest thing. What's this? Why isn't this working? Oh, did I put on invincibility? Oh, it was invincible. All right, this is really good. So there's a couple refills for health. Let's say you're down on health. You can come in here, grab some health. You're good to go. Oh. There's a lot going on today. Another GDC party tonight. What's up, Iragan? Yes, right on, man. UTC plus one. Where? Okay, let me guess. I don't know where to guess you're from. But I'm thinking it's either France, Germany, Italy. Is that UTC one? China, that's not UTC plus one. Can't be. So I'm trying to get my friend together and meet up tonight for some other... Netherlands! Ah, Netherlands, good guess. Norwegian! Norway! Oh! That's plus one, huh? Oh. I thought that was plus two or something. I guess I'm not. I've never lived in Europe, so I don't know. Alright, so I want to get my friend to the party tonight. meeting up again tonight. No more tickets. Might be able to sneak you in. Yeah. What's kind of great about GDC is you can get into a lot of parties that you didn't think you might. Greetings! How's it feel to live in the future? Alright, this is a great little thing. If you're, let's say you're down on health. Let's put an initial hurt on the player. Initial hurt of 2. Initial heal of 0. Yeah, so imagine you get to the boss room, the before boss room. You're really low on health. You can get powered back up. But it only gets you 2 hearts. So if you have like a ton of hearts or teeth, and then you come in this room and you're down, you're way down, you're really only gonna be back to 3. But still, that's better than refilling the health completely, because it takes away strategy that way. It takes away the reward of you playing through that dungeon well. So okay, that's great. In fact, I can probably just check that in so far. It's a good little tiny commit. Boss music. You can predict much? Nice. Nice. Gameness. Okay, so next goal is to make the item when you kill this boss ride in on a beam of light. This is gonna be cool. So set that back to initial hurt 0. In fact, I'll go to my save for save 1, put that to 0, 0. Copy over save 1 again. Should be nothing, no changes yet. And here we go. Okay, so when we create the item chest that's in area, here's where we create the item entity. Now it's not going to be purchasable, it's not an empty container, it's either hidden or visible or boss. So we always have the item component, so we don't need a collision component, we don't need a health component either. So let's see if this is boss. Do we have any boss flags here yet? What's up, Teak? How you doing, man? All right, yeah, it was chicken boss there. That doesn't really count. Okay, cool. So right here, hidden visible container, hidden visible slash beam of light container. So this is going to be the beam of light if flags and k flag boss. This is the hidden container. So the beam of light does nothing. Doesn't need any of these collision components, health components, blah, blah, blah. Just has an item component. Oh, it needs collision activate on complete though. Okay, so we do need a collision component. All right, so we got no filter, so it can never be touched. The size, I guess it can have a size. But we want activate complete. We don't want change HP or 0 HP. We don't want no remove. We just want activate complete. So that'll give us a way to activate this thing. But for now, I'm going to run this, and pretty much it shouldn't even create the item. Thanks, you reckon? You're splitting up your old sprite map into single sprites. Ah, so much copy and paste. Oh. Okay, I'm just gonna kill him with the cheat code. It still came up. It treated it like a container anyways in activate complete. All right, so this is coming along actually nicely. Shouldn't take too much longer actually to make this item ride down on a beam of light. So activate collision complete. Here we go. So this is where we lower the shield. This is where we reveal a hidden container. Okay, this is, we'll call this open container. This is reveal a hidden container, and we're gonna do this if we have collision activate, change HP? Yeah, if we can change the hit points of this container, then we're just gonna add some flags so that it opens up when it's done. That's revealing a hidden container. Now we're going to do beam of light. So we should get here. Set a breakpoint there. Let's just pretend the movie does not exist. So I'm killing once again with my cheat codes. Squiggly brackets? No, you don't need them. Squiggly brackets? What? You don't always need them. Here we go. Okay, so yeah, we're hitting this beam of light thing. Okay, I want to make sure that the other hidden containers are not broken at this point, which means I should look at the map and find a hidden container. Yeah, one line. All right, so where we got hidden? Here we go, hidden container right there, which is southwest. Okay, so when I go to this room and destroy all the enemies in this room, we should still be able to get the regular. Wait, south. Is this level 9? This does not look at all like the same level. What the hell? What's level 1? Oh, duh. Oh, level 1. All right. Well, let's just go to level 9 real quick. Make sure this is working. I don't want to break anything else when I add new stuff. Just got to test little things here and there. Make sure things are working. It makes it easier when I go to the point where I'm doing my playthroughs for this version. Oh, wow. There's a lot of enemies here. Oh, no. Maybe did I already have the item here? Do I add an empty line after print? Do you mean, do you, does a person need to, or am I? What you're talking about? You mean like in general? Like in general, after you do a print statement, do you put a? I don't think it really matters in C++. It really just matters your braces. So this should be the hidden item place. What item is this? What do we got here? Map 9? Do I have map 9 already? Shouldn't have map 9. No, don't have map 9. Okay, so something was definitely wrong there. Should have revealed the hidden item there. Why didn't it? Let's see if we even get here. Actually, you know what? Before I even mess with that, I want to see how it's creating it. Make sure this part's right here. We should be hitting that breakpoint. It should be doing this one. Oh, you're using Java. Oh, see, that might be a little different. I'm not exactly sure. I don't use Java myself. Okay, good. We're getting there. Oh, but it did flag boss. Oh, we're in the other room. We want to go south, southwest. So that would be 7, 4. All right, so this time, yes, we got a hidden container. Good. Run that. Let's kill all. Oh, here we go. It worked that time. You know what happened? I think it actually placed an enemy on top of that hidden container. Oh, you know what? That's probably what it was, huh? Let me go over one room to the right. Because it seems like the placement of the enemies was different that time. Yeah, you could definitely learn. You know, learning one will teach you another. A little bit. Okay, I don't need to see that anymore. That's good. Yeah, check it out. See, there's a pile. There's a pile of them there in the middle. Oh wait, it did activate that. Hold on. Let's re-enable breakpoints. You never seen those jellyfish mobs? Yeah, they're cool. They're really hard. They're really tough guys. They have tons of hit points and they're like dog on the bone. Whoops. Here we go. So it should be revealing the container. It's got that flag. Oh, yes. Okay, this totally makes sense. So it's adding the flags. Everything's cool. The container's ready to pop up, but there's an enemy on top of it. That's why they're not coming up. So this is really important that I just found this, man. So this hidden container needs category filter invalid pause. That'll make it so that it can't put enemies on top of it. Brainsteins. No Bafu. Dope, didn't work. So what if this was filter container? For some reason we're not getting this to pop up. And it's because it's putting spiders on top of it. Yes, they already have a name. They're called Ray Meeks. Meatballs? Yeah, still we got nothing. So it doesn't really matter there. I'm pretty sure this is right if I go invalid pause. All right, so I'm going to look at the placement. The placement of the spider sacks. Is there something special going on with those? Nope. It's going to be then in create AI. Meet the balls. How do you draw your stuff so that whenever it's behind something gets drawn first? It's called a Z order. Z ordering. You put a Z order like of one for something that's low. And then a Z order of two for something that's a little higher than that. And that's how you make sure everything is in the right Z. What do they do? They're just really tough. They're tough enemies. Okay, so what is it? It's placing the enemy, I believe. Where is it doing it? Furlock, pulverizer, reward item. Let's figure it out. Set a breakpoint there. Oh, if it's a, if the name equals sack, set a breakpoint. So I'm still trying to figure out why the sack is not. It should be setting a appropriate position. For the enemy, for the sack. Based on. Based on all the other entities that have already been created, and it's already created the whole area. So, oh, has it created the items yet? Probably not. Oh my god, that would make sense. Oh, okay, hold on. Create items. It's being called right here. It's where it places the items. It does this lampatron, light beams. Yep, items was after foes. So there's NPCs, appears foes. There we go. Okay, so this is kind of a reorder here. I'm doing saved items and then items. So I do need to test this a lot. Yeah, they charge you. They're basically just a physical enemy at this point. They don't have any kind of ranged attack yet. I think, but I'm liking this concept of enemies getting a lot more intense and having more abilities the deeper you go into the dungeon. So I think these guys will have some more abilities they will enable depending on the difficulty of the dungeon you're currently in. What the hell? Just broke that code. Unbreak the code, man. Unbreak it. They create a complaint post on Reddit. Make them teleport? That's an interesting idea, Hardboil. They could teleport. Didn't work. It should have been smart enough to not place the sack enemy right there. So we can see where it's supposed to be. Let's go no foes for a second. Just make sure that that thing is there. That doesn't make any sense. Was anything there? Maybe I got the wrong room. No, I don't have the wrong room. I think it's just not actually triggering an activate complete because... Wait, it should. Hold on. We should get that happening. Oh, there's a problem. It's checking for collision category none. Oh my god, has it been doing that the whole time? Here we go. So let's check for none or invalid pause. And yes, we should hit this breakpoint. Let's see that happen. A boss of a brain attached to a purple bear. Where does the purple bear come from? What's this purple bear idea? Still nothing. We didn't hit that breakpoint. What the hell? Alright, I'm gonna disable this one for a second. Evil con carne? I like you, Hardboiled, you're funny. Hey, the spiders were stuck inside it. Yeah, check it out. We're getting this. Activate no collision, remove the complete flag, give it a mask. That thing is totally ready to pop up. So wait, if I do no foes once again. I get it now. See, here it is. It's not popping up. Oh, okay. So maybe it wasn't a bug with... Shoot, this could have been a big bug in the last version. Yes, you're not going to use collision rectangles. You see all these rectangles everywhere? All these red things are collision. Activate no collision is the problem. Oh. No. It could be that E collision category needs to be none. There we go. Awesome. So, man, it's a good thing I checked all this. All right, so now let's put back on foes. I don't really need any more of that. What you mean? Yeah, check it. It's not working. What? It, so it definitely placed an enemy right on top. Yep, see that? The corner of this enemy is right on top of this... this tile, which is... it's really good we found this bug. Just gotta get it fixed. Why is it still not putting in... it should be invalid pausing it. Alright, so once again, we're gonna go back to area creation. Am I at 60 frames a second? Why is the... oh, right. Yeah, optimize and unnoticeable. Yeah. As long as you do you can do rectangles right. As long as your art fits rectangles, then you can get away with just using rectangles for collision detection. So I want to enable this one here. And find out why it's placing the sack wrong. Why is it placing the sack wrong? Wrong sacking. Sack wrong. Alright, let's figure it out. Furlock pulverizer. Here we go. Yeah, so it's doing the right, it's in the right section of code that I thought it was in. Mask is... ooh, this thing can't move, can it? Wait. Well, yeah. No, it can't. This is the... oh. Okay, so this has no mask, which means that it's using the default mask. The default mask, does it have invalid pause? No. Oh my god, that's the problem. All right, fixed it. Boom. So when we're placing an enemy, and we're doing this mask right here, and we're gonna do K filter default or K filter invalid pause. Enemies always need invalid pause to check against. Right, let's make that clear. This is area pause Z0, overworld. There. So now when I walk into this room, it should not be able to place any kind of enemy, no matter if they have a move component, on top of a hidden container. Pixel correct? 32,000 objects? It looks like it might be working. Oops. Disable that. Delete that, actually. Yeah, look, it happened. It worked. It's good. Fix the bug. Doing the fix a bug dance, doing the fix a bug dance. What's up, Zynger? Welcome to today's stream. Okay, I'm using my cheat code to kill everything. Yep, fixed it. Boom. And if I happen to have this item already, I save, reload, whoop, yep, it already has that container revealed. Beautiful. Alright, we're ready to do what I've been trying, setting out to do all stream. So, first of all, let's check us in. We reordered the way items are created, so that items can be created with an invalid position, and then foes can check against that invalid position. So we've got a beam of light type of container ready to go, but we need to implement it still. The hidden containers are using an invalid pause, so that means that enemies can't be on top of it. This is just a reorder there. This is the key to making the hidden containers work, that or the enemies not be placed on the invalid pause. And then this is where we open the container. If it's none or invalid pause, then we reveal the hidden container or let it ride down on a beam of light. So we call this a beam of light prep. All right, so now all we got to do is make the item actually appear on a beam of light. You didn't check into Git for a week? Oh, dude, start checking in right now. Hey. Can you believe I've never ever seen that movie, that show, or whatever that is? It's called Grease, right? Isn't that the movie Grease? Or is that some show based on Grease or something like that? Whatever it is, I've never seen it. Never want to. Yeah, so the beam of light. Collision system right in on a beam of light. So, how are we going to do this? First of all, we're going to need a beam of light. We're going to need the item to ride in. I guess the first thing to do is to verify that we can even create this item. So we're going to get the item component. Oh, we already got the item component. What am I doing? It's not empty. So we're going to set the item to none, so this can never happen again. We've already disabled complete anyways. And then we'll create the item. So world area create item. Item.type. Put it right in the center of the screen. Untracked files? Oh, Teak, man. Get on that. Ragan, when you use animations, do you have them saved in some kind of array or an image sheet? It's a sprite sheet. Yep, sprite sheet. Let me show you. Yep, so here's one example of like a bajillion sprites. And then to use different animations, what I do is like I'll name everything for like the hero running to be hero running 1, hero running 2, hero running 3. And then I have some code which goes and checks to see if these sprite sheets or these sprites, these individual sprites inside the sprite sheet exist for running 1, running 2, running 3. When it finds one and it's not found, it's like, okay, that animation is 3 frames long. So we can auto-detect how long an animation is based on a format string that you give it. And so it's all quite simple. Simple to use. Automatic. Everything should be automatic if it can be, right? Save yourself time. Make your game's development rapid. So area.getSize, that's a V3F. Multiply that by half. That's where we want this thing to appear. Create item status, false, true, 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 true. We want to remember this. And the next things are velocity. We'll go 0 velocity. And float height, we'll do a little bit of float height. So there, this is not how we want it to work, but this is just confirming that this is beam of light thing is gonna work. First we'll just put the player. Killing him once again with my cheat code. So right at the very end, this item container emitted its item. The demons do. We put it in the middle. So the next step is to make it animate, to make it float in from the top. We're on a good track here. When you use animation, oh, they are all distorted in the Y. How do you make it accurate with that? Distorted in the Y? What do you mean? Oh, are you talking about how it just rotated them all? No, there's no distortion going on, but there is rotation. I don't know. I lost my file that I was just showing you, but yeah, some of them are rotated, but oh, here it is. I'm not sure what you mean by distorted in the Y. Okay, so this is where it creates the item. Let's see if it returns. Yeah, it returns an ID. So we could just... Yeah, we could just take off floating, so it's not even floating at all. Or, oh, I guess we could just leave float on, because all float does is make it move up and down a little bit. Wait a minute, does floating even have the glow and the sparkle? We want the glow and the sparkle. No Pedro foo. What's up, Pedro? They're on different Y positions. I'm not sure what you mean by them being on different Y positions in the sprite sheet. In the sprite sheet, they're all at totally different positions. It's just that you check out how you should do a little tutorial on sprite sheets. Understand sprite sheets and how they work. Basically, all a sprite sheet is a texture where you have a whole bunch of different sub-sprites inside it, but they're to the texture, the texture has no idea. It doesn't matter the texture where the sub-sprite is. The texture just is the texture. It's full of all those different items, right? Or sprites. And then your code should have a property list. So I guess I didn't show you this other part of the room. Yeah, you should do a tutorial on this. See, this is how, there's two pieces to a sprite sheet. There's the texture. This is the texture file right here. It can be like a ping or a JPEG or whatever the hell you're using to store your texture. I'm using PBR here. And then you've also got the other component of a sprite sheet is a list of all the files inside. See this? This is a property list which has every single sprite before it was packed into the sprite sheet and shows what offset that sprite is at, the size of that sprite, the rectangle that it's going to use, whether it's rotated or not, all those things. So when your code loads your sprite sheet, you parse out this property list, and then you know of a whole bunch of different sprites inside it. Why aren't you booping? All right, so... this floating is all working good now. Wait, I guess, oh, I was checking if floating also has the glow. Why is it not floating? This is just other effects. Yeah. Okay. So going back to where we create this beam of light, I'm going to start creating a whole, I'm going to create all this animation here inside this function, but then I'm going to move it into NMs later. So now we're going to go ride the beam of light thing. So let's get the entity. Check if it has a render component, of course. Now we'll go f.render.schedule, no, sprite schedule. We're going to call a function a whole bunch of times until we're done. This is going to take a float, which we're going to ignore. Well, no. I guess we can keep that. The interval is going to be k ticks per second. Unsigned repeat is going to be the number of seconds that this is happening divided by k ticks per second. So let's get an overall duration for this. Const float. Or let's do double, const double duration is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm guessing about 5 seconds. So we'll go duration over k ticks per second. The delay, we want this to run right away. This key is gonna be called beam of light. Okay, so each call, we want this thing's, well, we need to capture the entity. If we do get to name something and I miss it, the name I vote for is Fluffords. Fluffords, huh? So this thing will go G position pause dot Z. We're going to be modifying the Z here. So we'll start off by moving it really high. Position dot pause. Dot Z is going to be 315 or so, and also modifying the old position Z. And then this is going to be G equals 315. I guess we could do const float max height 315 max height, capture that, set it times a percentage here. Okay, so that should do the basic motion for making the item float down from the ceiling. And then we'll add a platform underneath it. You have negative 1,000 points? Oh, this should be 1 minus. Oh, hold on.
Thank you.
Alright, Ragin, good night, man. Oh, it saw it there for a second. What's up, Nerdia? So, okay, what's happening here? What's up with this, man? What's up with this? Maybe percent's wrong. Alright, I'll just log out what position it's using. When in doubt, printf. Okay, what do we get by the... Oh, I didn't do it at all? Screw you. It didn't even log anything. Why not? Why are we not getting this? F, render, sprite, schedule. Okay, let's start there. I guess we should not be doing that for Z. Alright, we got the render. Set the pause. Scheduling here. Should be getting this. Nothing. Never called. What the hell? Okay, well, screw that. Let's not even do it this way. Let's go schedule it before tick. Schedule before tick. Okay, we're taking same function. We got delay interval count. Delay interval. Interval. This ticks per second. Count. What? This isn't right. Delay interval count. It is interval. Plus interval times I. Yeah, well, I guess it's just k ticks per second then. K ticks per second. Interval count is duration over k ticks per second. Yeah, so that's all we should need there. But now we have a variable we need to modify. So we'll do a static int I 0. And we always set I to 0. We can access I from inside this lambda and do clampf 01 1 minus the percentage, which is float I over float max. We need max here. Okay, let's see if that works.
Okay.
right, we're getting this breakpoint. Let's disable this one now. Nothing. Is it killing this item? What the heck? It's not overriding the id or anything. I guess I need this breakpoint. Schedule before tick and the other thing didn't work. It will ride in on a beam of light or a little platform. And I'm figuring out why it's not launching this whole effect. Schedule before tick. Max. What's max? Zero. What the hell? Oh. Wait, duration divided by k ticks per second. No, that's k seconds per tick. Duh. That's why it wasn't working before. Ah, we need that. Still need that. Disable this one. Okay, we should hit the breakpoint now. I'm telling you. I see it spawned it really quick there, but it should have been a different Z. Oh, we got this breakpoint. Yeah. Is it coming in? Oh, it's not. What the hell? What? Maybe it works if I turn off the breakpoint. Why is it broken all of a sudden? Oh man. Alright, so, this is one of those little things in game development I wish happened faster. I obviously made some kind of mistake here, which is costing me an expensive bit. Okay, we're hitting this. We got a duration, we got a max height, I is zero. The max is 149. Scheduling that, run it. We hitting this, nice. But it only hits it once. Yeah, we got item pause once and it never repeats. We got delay interval count. Delay zero, interval k ticks per second. Oh. Also k seconds per tick. Jeez, gotta stop and think, huh? Two little mistakes like that, 15 minutes. I just thought about it a little bit. Thanks forever and ever. Don't tell me it's still. Yeah, look at that. Okay, cool. We got item pause. But it's not moving the Z. We got max height times clamp F 01 float. Here, we need an I. I max. So float I over float max 1.0 minus that. Zero off. For fuck's sake, I didn't even increase I. Duh. I++. That's a really good move there. We keep that around. Okay, hopefully it works now, huh? 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 Awesome! Let's see if the collision works too. So if I stand underneath it. Standing up right where it should land. Fly target? Oh my god, what happened? Oh, you know what? It needs to break out of this schedule if it's been picked up. We got this. Okay, once again, I don't know how the hell it deleted the whole four just because of that. But that could totally happen. It would return an empty component and then set that component Z. It's totally wrong. Alright, so now we should have the item once again floating down from the sky. Stand underneath it. Picked it up right when it hit my head. Awesome. Okay, next thing we want a little platform underneath it. So let's draw a platform. Actually, let's check this in so far. This is pretty good. Other effects. Activate complete. Beam of light started. Boom. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is create a small little entity. It's like a little platform. The item will sit on, ride down. So I'm going to draw a tiny platform. Circular, well, oval shaped. Let's open up HUD so I can get an item. Let's get the HUD. How do the shadows work? They're simple 2D shadows. They take the regular sprite, flip it over, make it black, skew it. Real simple. Totally 2D. HUD, where are you? Oh, sprites. All right, I'm gonna grab this big old tooth. All right, so now I'm gonna have some room underneath it. So let's make this height 48, width also maybe around 48, maybe more like 64 for the width. This is obviously pretty big, but all right, so we'll go save as sprites level. This is where I put item chest and all that? One pillar. I'm actually going to save this in common. Call this one. I mean, chest. Well, I guess this is kind of a chest. This is kind of like an item. I should call it item platform, I guess. This is kind of the item platform. All right, I'm gonna color it the same as stone. Beep boop bop boop. So I'm going to open up level one, ground. It's going to be similar to something like this. Not quite as thick, but about like this. All right, we're ready to do this. So I can save that as we got it. And now I can mess with this bottom layer and just draw something cool. So it looks like a platform, circular or oval shaped. Let's start with this color here. And I'll draw, let's see, maybe about that big. I don't really need that layer anymore. Yeah, about this big. Wait, that's 30? I want 31. So it should be centered. 17, 16. Not what I meant. Let's do one more pixel there, so we should have 17. 17, and now squish it. So it's about 61.8%. It'll give us a nice perspective on it. Great, now we got a rough oval. I can go and get this exposed, this bottom layer here, so I can draw it, make it look cool like that. OK, get rid of this for a second. It's pretty good. We'll add in some, whoops. Add in a little bit of texturing. Let's add some highlight. Some shadow. And back to making it look like 3D. It's a little too much. Yeah, that's good. Right about there. Okay, so I can draw on top of this. Let's merge these. Take this first color. So now I'm going to add a little bit more dark to the bottom and give it some like wires or little antennae type thing coming off the bottom of it. That's all right. Okay, so this is looking. Now it needs some runes. Yeah, it's a good color. All right. So I'm gonna draw a new layer for these runes. That's pretty good. So that's kind of what it, roughly what it'll look like. I guess it needs a little bit more darkness in the middle. I want it to sink just a tad bit. Yeah, and I was excited as a little sunken bit. And I'm gonna reduce the opacity of the edges of these runes. Looks like it gets a little bit faded. Excuse me. And then randomly take out a little bit of these runes' opacity as well. That's pretty good. Oh, now it looks confusing in the middle. So I think I'm gonna have to remove these middle bits. That's a lot better. Cool. All right, I like this. Let's put this in the game. Check it out. All right, we got this centered. Let's see. We got 26 pixels there. 23 there. What's the total? 48. 24. Everything needs to move up at least a pixel, if not two. 24, that's good. And this should be still be centered, 17. Beautiful, all right, exporting this. Sheets, common, item platform. Call this item platform 0 in case I ever want to animate it. Save that. Let's get at it. All right, so when we create the item, we're also going to create, let's call this item id. We also want to create another entity that is the platform, put it right underneath it. So we'll go id platform id equals entity create. It's the lamest train ever. It stayed open for so long too. New position. position, render. C1. I think that's it. Just needs a position and a render, really. I could probably get away with just having a render. But I'd rather not. Okay, so now we'll capture the platform mid. And set its position based on the item's position. -1. And it probably needs some offsetting. You just noticed you're active on the stream for like 4 months. Oh my god, right? When did that happen? Whatever it was, whenever it was, I'm glad it happened, Arbald. Hrender. Oh, we don't wanna do that just yet. We wanna go. Platform render equals entity get render component. Of platform id and platform render dot sprite dot set anchor point kit offset anchor offset platform and offset. Okay, so usually we're like here, we want the offset for this thing to be like there, so 24 pixels. Oh, we could just set its anchor point. Really, a lot easier than doing this math. Oh well. Back to the offset is going to be, I think, we want this to be 24. This might even need to be negative 24. I'm not sure. Let's try that. I'm not even going to move it this time. See if it works this time. No platform. Ah, because we don't have it. Oh, because I need to use a zero? Zero, man, zero. All right, let's try it again. Moving this time. When you count to 10, you start with zero. Voice of Grog! Greetings! On this, making it so the demon's teeth always ride in on a platform from the sky, from the ceiling. This time did it work? No, it doesn't have item platform 0. Probably because I need to call raw pack. How else would you present Demon Seed, right? So this will be cool. It'll make it a little bit special for the Demon's Teeth. You know, every other item, you might have a hidden chest, you might have a regular chest, you might have a hidden inside an enemy, but always the Demon's Teeth are special and that they ride in from the sky. So this should really make defeating a boss a little bit more rewarding. Offset wrong. Okay. And I think it can move now. Let's make this negative 24. I think that's what we need there. Did it also drop on the enter key afterwards? What? Oh, you dropped your chapstick. Oh, I was like... You type 23? Z is wrong. So we want platform render dot Z or dot Z order offset always negative one. Oh, and this is a good way to do it. If not G is empty, do this. Okay, so this is, we're gonna set position. Oh, Z pause. Float Z pause now. If not G, position.empty. Move that. Not H.position.empty. Do this. Maybe both be Z pods actually. Color it. We need to color it. Platform render dot sprite dot set color area get color mix. Okay, color rock at X Y. We don't want X Y. We want pause. Pause. Maybe make the platform come from the ground. No, that would change everything. Why would, how would it come from the ground? And besides, there's already a hidden chest that comes from the ground. I really want this to be epic looking. Like, the point is that it rides in from the sky. No other item does this. Float height. We don't want a float height anymore. We want like a float height of maybe one. We can do negative 23 there, so maybe 22, and it should look nice. Yeah, it's starting to look better. Properly. Okay. So once it's done, if we got if, I guess we could, nah. Yeah, if we go if I is max minus one, we're done, which means h dot render dot z order layer becomes kz low, and the h dot render dot z order offset becomes, oh, maybe 10-ish. And then also we want to change the tile z at this current position. So world area set tile z. I guess let's do add tile z at the position h dot position dot pause. The z, I want it to be like 4, so it's a really pops up and out. Min 0, max 4, so it allows it. So let's see if those two things work. We want, okay, I can make this, cast this to V2F. So two things should happen there. One, it should be under your feet all the time. And two, in the middle of it, it should have a z position that's higher, so it looks like you're stepping up on top of it. And the Z worked as well. Nice, 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 nice. Beep, 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 beep. Yay, it all works. It all works well. Last piece of this puzzle, I'm gonna make this a separate function so this doesn't have to clog up this whole collision system thing. All it needs is an item type passed in. Yeah, all right. Okay, so this is going to be enims. Void, we'll call this item platform. And we need an item type. Is that it? I guess we'll do a duration on this. Float duration. Okay, let's get that compiling. Names.cpp, start the method. Back to here, yank out all this code. Call nims item platform and a duration of 5 seconds. Back here, put all this code here where it belongs. Inside its own animation type method. Create item. Create platform. Animate. Just animate. Call this the item type so we can actually use item properly. Item type, where's our duration? Here we go, we got duration, we don't need to copy that. Max height, that could be as it is. All right, next thing, this here can be called, we can call this the item. We call this one just item two and this one platform. There we go. Hey, what's up, Hardline? Okay, so now I just need to check this. It didn't break anything with all that code refactoring I just did. And then we're ready to check it in. It's a cool new effect where the demon's tooth rides in on a beam of light on some platform. Oh, it needs a beam of light. I forgot. Chest there. Oh, Hardline, the basics aren't that hard. Start with some simple tutorials. And it's good to be excited, right? So we need to check that if we have flags boss, we're not creating an empty container at all. Actually, we need to just skip this whole loop. I was working on Unity 3D tutorials, but I use C# and I'm learning Java. Well, why don't you use, what's the Java engine called? LiveGDX. Why don't you use LiveGDX, man? Do some simple LiveGDX tutorials. Test. I want to make sure that it, if I don't even get the item, that it does recreate it. Oh, comes out again. Why did that happen? Oh, I guess because everything's already been flagged and all that, so we don't want to, when we create the item here, we do not want to remember, we don't want to create an item status, so false. The music's overlapping. Oh, it should have done that. I was in God mode and all that. I'm speeding things up and using cheat codes and all this stuff, so the music's gonna overlap when I... the same track twice. Okay, yeah, there's definitely something wrong with that. And it's still creating the item twice. Oh, you know what? Area, create item. Yeah, that pushes it back as an entity. Let's see if it works if I let the item come all the way down. It might have doubled up the item and did the audio twice. Or the first part is doubling up the item here, and then I'll check the music. So this time I'm going to let the platform ride all the way down and see if it might have something to do with that. No, see, it still creates it. Right away. Including the platform, which is really weird. I think I need to check in so far. This is it's a good check in so far to get like this atomic and all that. Item platform. Do it a third time. What's up? Kane? Is it Kane? Cyan? You can make a remix just going back and forth, back and forth. Okay, next curiosity is the first thing to solve before the music doubling up is why does it put two platforms? And why am I so hungry? Why am I so hungry? Has it been 2 hours already? It has been 2 hours. Okay, let me see if I can at least fix this one little bug before the stream is done. So I want to make it so When you don't pick up the item, it doesn't create two of them. Cyan, all right. How do you open Live GDX? I don't know. I haven't used it myself. Okay. Food is just around the corner, brain. Promise you. I guess it's triggering the platform twice? Let's see. Set a breakpoint here. Every time it creates this item platform, we'll see where and why. Okay, collision system activate. It's calling activate complete. Items riding in on a video flight. I go somewhere else. Come back. See, it was just still there already. It hasn't even created this item platform yet. Okay, this is the curious part. Why is the item just already there?
What's up, baby?
All right, so why is the item just already there? Already has a platform too. It's like, wait, what if I run away from the boss and don't even fight him? Yeah, it definitely doesn't create two of those. I think I understand. The platform was never added as an entity. Thanks, Pedro. Okay, so we need a method from area called create item platform. I think just the position ought to do. Yeah, we position, platform, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Let's get that compiling. back in area, create item, platform. Do I have a schedule for streaming? Not a strict schedule, but yes, I have a rough schedule. I stream usually weekdays, sometimes weekends, and usually it's actually always about this time. So there you go. It's a very rough schedule. It's very kind of random. The best way to, if you really want to follow me, or I mean, if you really want to catch my live streams, the best way is to click follow and get the email notification. So whenever I actually am going live, you'll get a little notification. Okay, so we're going to grab this platform id from this function, area.createItemPlatform for at pause. All this stuff goes inside that method. So this should solve half the problem. Hold on. We got to push this back. That was the whole point. Push back. Id. There. So now that it's an area entity, it will not get lost in other entities. Basically, won't leak itself. And we probably call, yeah, properly calling that. Good. Should be able to compile successfully. Run it. And this time, when we kill the boss, watch the platform come down, go off the screen, come back. It should not have the platform, but I'm expecting it to still have the item. What I'm assuming is going on there with the item is that it's recreating the item from the item create methods, and it shouldn't do that, so. Let's check this out. Phase one of this little fix. That time it created a hidden chest, though, underneath. See that? There's a hidden chest right here. Okay, so yeah, we're almost there. Almost got this fixed. In area, back where it creates the item. Set a breakpoint. I'm going to step through this and understand why. Oh, it's probably creating a hidden component. Okay, we need to make this function a little smarter. I'm going to call this bool item platform. It's called, no, do item platform. Flags and K flag boss. All right, and else if do item platform, also the name is going to be, well, it would be empty. Here we got do item platform. Also, there's one more thing. Here, if has and do item platform. There. Hopefully all that logic works. A couple things to check now. Just get in there, check it. And that's gonna be about it for today's stream. Day 331, I think, making Songbringer. Getting close to a year now of dev days. We're not counting weekends in that. Oh, broken! Broken! What did I break? Frame, get a sprite frame, reveal. All right, so hidden. Basically, we don't want the hidden flag if we're doing the item platform. Yeah, thanks you guys. Platform gets recreated. Oh, it does do the Z. Look at that. There's a little hump here. Okay. So that's it for today's stream. Thanks for watching, everybody. Yeah, so I'm working towards getting this, getting an update out to Steam at the earliest tomorrow, maybe Saturday. And yeah, so that will be another beta update for Songbringer out on Steam. Available to anyone that's pre-ordered the game or backed the game. So if you're interested in that, if you're just joining the stream, you're like, what is this? This game is called Songbringer. It's a procedurally generated Zelda-like game, and it's on. You can pre-order the game at songbringer.com/pre-order if you want to play the beta. So cheers, everybody.